يا يحيى خذ الكتاب بقوة وآتيناه الحكم صبيا
إذ قال الله يا عيسى إني متوفيك ورافعك إلي
محمد رسول الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. سورة الأنفال، سورة that was revealed to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in المدينة. And the battle of Badr is mentioned in the surah with some details. Shows the victory of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a miraculous day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called it Yawm al-Furqan, the day of the criterion where the truth and falsehood, they became distinct from one another. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave victory to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the companions radiallahu anhum when they were so much outnumbered by the disbelievers, when all of the physical means would say that the believers would receive a severe defeat, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed something else. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed something, all the means would fall according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed. And we talked about that in the verses before, from 40 to and afterwards. And inshallah ta'ala, in this episode, we'll get to know some of the lessons learned, some of the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this Quran to stay till the day of judgment, even though there are specific incidents that happen at the time of the Prophet ﷺ, but what matters for those who are alive after the Prophet ﷺ is to take the lesson from what is being mentioned. And that's the way of the Quran. It's not about a story or to say things, you know, based on what history mentioned, and it's not how historical matters, but rather for people to learn from it. Because the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always repeated, and that's why the believers, they seek strength from these types of verses to be steadfast upon the deen of Allah. We'll go through inshallah ta'ala verses from Surah Al-Anfal from 45 to 48, from verse number 45 to 48, and some of the lessons learned from the Battle of Badr. So let's start with verse number 45 from Surah Al-Anfal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا لَقِيتُمْ فِئَةً فَثْبُتُوا وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ, which means, O you who have believed, when you encounter a company from the enemy forces, stand firm and remember Allah much that you may be successful. So this is a call to the believers, and putting in perspective the Battle of Badr and what happened in it, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought the two parties together without any previous appointment or any plans or anything that they planned for. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the victory to the Prophet ﷺ and the companions radiallahu anhum when nobody would ever expect such a victory. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now is calling the believers, and you see how the call is to all of the believers, not just to the companions radiallahu anhum, but to all the believers at all times till the Day of Judgment. And as we heard before many times, once a believer hears this call from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, it gives honor, gives dignity. That the caller is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he's calling the believers. So they find this honor and dignity in being believers. And that's why as a Muslim we have to have this honor and dignity in the deen of Islam. That's what gives us the happiness of this life and in the hereafter, because this is the truth that a person needs to be upon. Also gives the sense of responsibility that after this call, there's either an order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you are ordered to do, or something that you are forbidden from doing. So a person would put himself in a position where, now this is the call for the believers, what is the call? What is the order for me to submit myself to it? What is the thing that we are forbidden from doing, so that we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. So great benefits when a person hears, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. And should we act with the book of Allah in such a way that we apply the orders of Allah in our life. And again, some of the orders or some of the calls might be not something related to each and an individual Muslim. It can be for the people of authority, for example. It can be for a judge. It can be for whatever position that the person is upon, or a person have a family, you know, and you would find يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا أَيُّهُ بِلِيفٍ. So each person, according to the context of the verses, is very important to know who's addressed by it, and also at the same time to learn the rulings, because a person never know what position that he might take, all by the will of Allah. So this call from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the believers, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا إِذَا لَقِيتُمْ فِئَةً, if you meet a group of people, meaning your enemies in the battlefield. So this is to the believers, those who would fight for the sake of Allah, the people of authority. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ordering them that if already it's happened and you have to meet your enemies and you are right there in the battlefield, then what should you do? فَثْبُتُوا. فَثْبُتُوا, that means be firm, stand firm. That's the first order. وَذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا, and make remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala much, frequently, so much. لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ, so that you are successful. So there's something to be established, and orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala depends on a specific situation, and the outcome also is mentioned in this verse. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, one time in one of the battles, he said to the people that لَا تَتَمَنَّوا لِقَاءَ الْعَدُوِ, do not yearn, do not wish to meet your enemies. وَسَلُوا اللَّهَ الْعَفِيَ, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for strength. Do not wish that you would meet your enemies, but rather ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for strength. فَإِذَا لَقِيْتُمُوهُمْ فَاصْبِرُوا, but if you meet them, then be patient. So this is what needs to be in the hearts of the believers. They don't seek to meet their enemies and to fight them and so on. But if that happened, that they would have to face this inevitable, that means they need to be patient. And if this is what they do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide them and give them victory. And the Prophet ﷺ would make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give victory to the believers. So this is the orders of Allah. This is the way of the Prophet ﷺ. Whoever do not follow the orders of the Prophet ﷺ, then the opposite happens to them. They become defeated. And that's why a person should abide by the orders of Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا أَيُّهُ بِلِيفٍ إِذَا لَقِيْتُمْ فِئَةً, now you face your enemies. Now you are in the battlefield. So the order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not to flee. Otherwise this is a major sin. فَثْبُتُوا, be firm. You know, if what makes a person flee is being a coward, being outnumbered by the disbelievers, whatever there is. And therefore the believers, they need to have the courage. And one of the dua of the Prophet ﷺ, that he would say after each salah, after each fard salah. So you can imagine 5 times a day for this dua to be mentioned for the entire life of the Muslim. And this dua, اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الجبن وأعوذ بك أن أرد إلى أرض العمر وأعوذ بك من فتنة الدنيا وأعوذ بك من عذاب القبر. Seeking refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every time the Prophet ﷺ finished the salah, Wallahi, I seek refuge in you from al-jubn, from being a coward, for being scared of other than Allah. That makes a person run away from what is important and things of that nature. Sometimes it's even make the person disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And seeking refuge in Allah, not to reach an old age that makes a person is not able to function or to lose his strength and so on. And also seeking refuge in Allah from the fitna, the trial of this dunya, of this world, and the punishment in the grave. So this is something that shows the believers they need to have courage in their hearts. They need to have strength in their hearts. Why? Because they rely upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that is able to do all things. So why fear other than Allah? Do not fear anyone but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But also it shows that it doesn't mean that the person is having courage is that he yearn and wish to meet his enemies. No, because the Prophet ﷺ said, do not wish that you would meet your enemies. But if you meet them, then be courageous. Gain that strength from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَثْبُتُوا, be firm, don't flee, because that's a major sin. But then what would help the person to be firm and steadfast? وَذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا, and make remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala much, kathiran. Make remembrance of Allah not once in a while, not little, but rather so much. And that shows how the importance of the dhikr, and how the dhikr has a physical effect in the lives of the people, give you strength. The dhikr is one of the means to give strength to the hearts. as the ayah is clear and clear evidence to this. And that's why this is such a great lesson for each and every one of us to learn and to reflect upon. And especially when the times are fitting and people, they try to make others weak and makes the hearts weak. Make people think that your enemies will do this to you, they will do this to you, they will destroy you, they would, you know, make remembrance of Allah. Be firm upon your deen. Do not compromise your deen because of the fear of other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They will tell you, they will stop you, they will do this, they will do that. Why? When you are innocent of any crime, when you are someone that is, all of your objective is to be obedient to Allah, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and so on. So fathbutu, be firm, wadhkuru Allah kathiran, make frequent remembrance of Allah. And that's to the people in the battlefield. And you can imagine when a person in the battlefield, his heart is concerned of how to save himself from being killed, how to bring victory and so on. And in that midst of all of this, if it's so-called stress in this case, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ordering the believers in this situation to make a lot of remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you can imagine if this is the case, then what would be the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the believers when they're not in the battlefield? To quit making remembrance of Allah? Or even it's going to be more and more? It shows the importance of the dhikr. How can it give strength to the people in these types of difficult situations and also at times of ease? And what is the reason for that? لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ, so that you will be successful. So this is the criteria, this is the means for success. To be firm and to make remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Such a great verse and a powerful verse when it comes to the battle of Badr in all times. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ordering the believers to be firm if you have to meet them. What if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had made the believers see the real numbers of the disbelievers? As it's mentioned before, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the believers see the disbelievers as less in number, then ordering them to be firm. So even if you get to know, and you're already meeting, facing your enemies, if you get to know that there are much more in your number and so on, be firm and make remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the next verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continuing with this order, how to give victory, how these are the means of being well established and to be given the victory from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Verse number 46, وَأَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا فَتَفْشَلُوا وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ وَاصْبِرُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. Very clear instructions. And obey Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And do not dispute and thus lose courage, and then your strength would depart, and be patient. Indeed, Allah is with the patient. So adding more to the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether it's with meeting the enemies or without meeting the enemies, to be firm, to make remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala much, and another order, وَأَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ, obey Allah and His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. All of that if you want to be successful, obey Allah and His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم at all times, at all of your affairs. When the Prophet ﷺ was alive among the people and when the Prophet ﷺ returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be obedient to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that requires knowledge, to know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us, to be upon what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us, and to submit oneselves to the orders of Allah and the way of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَأَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ, two orders. And then the third, وَلَا تَنَزَعُوا, do not be in dispute. This is another one. We'll talk about each and every one of them because we are in need of this. وَلَا تَنَزَعُوا, do not dispute. Then otherwise, فَتَفْشَلُوا, you would be in loss. You would be perished. You would lose courage and therefore you would be defeated. وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ, and your strength will depart. You won't have any strength anymore. And another order, وَصْبِرُوا, and be patient. Because indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with the sabireen. He's with those who are patient, with them to give them victory, with them to support them. So how to be patient is by fulfillment of the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll talk about this and reflect upon this and more of the verses to come inshallah ta'ala, but right after the break, so stay with us inshallah.
Muhammadur Rasulullah. Muhammadur Rasulullah.
Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala Rasulillah. Welcome back, and with verses number 45 to 48 from Surah Al-Anfal. and lessons learned from the Battle of Badr, great lessons, how the victory of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is attained, and how we as Muslims, we need to listen to the words of Allah. This is, overpowers the physical means. You know, people are so much attached to the physical means. There's nothing wrong with taking the physical means. But what governs the physical means, if it's correct to say, are the religious means, are the means that we get to know in the Quran and in the authentic Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that all of the means are created by Allah. So if someone is taking the religious means, the obedience of Allah, as we heard, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ordering the believers after the Battle of Badr, giving them instructions how to attain success in this life and hereafter, how to gain victory against your enemies, to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to fulfill the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then, as we heard in verse number 46, وَأَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ, be obedient to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not just in what relates to the battlefield, in all of your affairs, in everything, in matters of your ibadah, in your worship, in your desires, in halal, in haram, in relationships, in anything. وَأَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ, do not think that you know what is best for you. Do not say, but they would do this, or this will happen, and that will, you do not know what's going to happen. You need to be obedient to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes, if something that has no clear order from Allah or His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then we exert, of course, the means to establish whatever is good. But whenever there's an order from Allah or the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, people need to submit themselves and to be obedient to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is again the criteria for success. And the next order, وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا, do not be in disputes. Again, it's repeated here. Do not be in disputes. Do not dispute with one another. The subject of dispute, when people are together facing their enemies, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is warning against the dispute. Because what happened to the people when they are in dispute, they become weak, they fail. Their enemies take over them. This is in the animal life, and it's in the human beings too. And this is something that is well known to the people. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ordering the believers, وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا, do not be in dispute. If they are in the battlefield, they have a ruler, they have a leader, they are ordered to obey him in matters of ma'ruf and matters of goodness. And the people, when they have a ruler, when they have an authority, they obey them in matters of ma'ruf. And they do not obey them if it's a sin, but they don't dispute with one another, the believers, whether it's in a small community like a masjid, for example, or in household, or the entire ummah under authorities and so on, do not have these disputes, do not dispute with one another. And there are many different things that people can be disputing upon. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is warning us. And that's not mean, does not mean that people should not enjoy good and forbid evil and call the people to the truth. This is about those who are upon the truth. Do not dispute with one another. Do not expect that everybody will be perfect. People are bound to make mistakes. And there are etiquettes and rulings how to deal with the mistakes. So, وَلَا تَنَزَعُوا, do not be in disputes. And again, the goal is to be obedient to Allah. So if someone would explain this in the sense that if you are dealing with a disbeliever or a sinner, do not dispute. It's not like this. It's basically people, they need to advise one another. They need to enjoin good and forbid evil. And part of the forbidding good, forbidding the evil and enjoining the good, is that, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, that how the first deficiencies that happened to the people of Bani Israel is that the people of knowledge, the people of righteousness, would enjoin good and forbid the evil. But then they come back the next day, and the people upon evil are still upon the evil, so they won't find any harm in eating with them and sitting with them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, made their hearts against one another. So when there's no enjoining good and forbidding evil, when people would allow themselves to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and those who are upon knowledge and upon righteousness, they don't forbid the evil, they act as if they are approving the evil, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring their own misery and make their hearts against one another. So being obedient to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that's what lead the people not to be in disputes. Because if they're obedient to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, why there will be disputes? Because any dispute that people have towards one another, either it's because of the lack of knowledge, or there are diseases in the hearts, and both are to be removed with being obedient to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So when people do not know the rights of people of authority, they might think that we have to revolt against them, and that's ignorance, and that's what brings all kinds of disputes among the people. So knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be obedient to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say with regards to dealing with the people of authority? And that is isma'u ata' or ati'u da amrikum. That means be obedient to those who are in charge of you. Matters of goodness, not in matters of sins, of course. And when people are enjoining good and forbidding the evil, because this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us to be upon, therefore the niza' or the disputes, then something that they can push away from themselves. So wala tanaza'u, especially the battlefield, in the context of facing your enemies, فَتَفْشَلُوا. And as a result of the dispute, you will be in loss. You will be defeated. You would lose the courage, you would lose the steadfastness because of the disputes. That means the disputes affects the hearts. That's why people again need to be away from disputes, especially when they are dealing with their enemies. And they need to be together in dealing with what makes Muslims a Muslim. And then, of course, it doesn't mean again not to forbid the evil or to enjoin what is good. فَتَفْشَلُوا وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ. And your strength will be blown away. You won't have any strength anymore. The disbelievers will defeat you so easy if you have disputes. So this is what we see nowadays as Muslims, and that's what we need to learn from this. And the Quran is revealed for guidance to all mankind. For the believers, this is a call to the believers. So the believers, when they see this, would they still continue to be in disputes? That's something that is very sad reality that people need to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا فَتَفْشَلُوا وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ. And your strength will depart, will go away. Another order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then what happens if sometimes things you would find yourself that you have to be in some form of a dispute because there are issues, that things are not done right or whatever there is. وَاصْبِرُوا. Be patient. Because indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with the patient ones. What is the meaning of being patient? Being patient with the orders of Allah. Be upon the obedience of Allah. Be patient away from sins. Being patient with the qadr of Allah, one of which is in matters of battlefield, rulers and so on. Be patient, but that does not mean to disobey Allah. It does not mean for you to commit sins. But be patient and do whatever is good and ma'roof and matters of goodness, and do not cause disunity among the people. Why? Because this will cause defeat. It can even cause bloodshed, can even cause all kinds of fitna and tribulations. So people need to be together, united upon the truth. And if there is something that is wrongdoing and so on, then they should distance themselves, but without causing any disunity into the ummah of the Prophet ﷺ. Wasbiru, have patience, because indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with the sabirin. Ma'as sabirin means with them, to give them victory, to support them, to make all kinds of goods for them. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned against the ways of the disbelievers and how their affairs is totally different than how the believers are. The believers are humble. The believers, they do things for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They don't want glory for themselves, but they're seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So the next verse number 47, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ خَرَجُوا مِنْ دِيَارِهِمْ بَطَرًا وَرِئَاءَ النَّاسِ وَيَصُدُّونَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ مُحِيطٌ. Which means, and do not be like those who came forth from their homes incidentally and to be seen by people and avert them from the way of Allah. And Allah is encompassing of what they do. وَلَا تَكُونُوا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the most merciful. After He called the believers to observe certain things so that they are successful in this life and in hereafter, encouraging them, saying to them that He is with the sabireen and how to be successful, the verses are muhkamat, are clear verses. This is not ambiguity. This is not just words of wisdom for people to read it and they would say, mashallah, sounds great, but then is it applicable in our life? This is not like this. This is the words of Allah. This is something that we will be asked about it in the day of resurrection. That's why we need to again refer to the people of knowledge to understand and to act according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. So after ordering the believers to be obedient to Allah and His Messenger sallam, not to dispute, otherwise they would be in loss and their strength will depart. And indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with the patient ones. then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warning the believers from some of the characteristics of the disbelievers, that we are ordered to distant ourselves from them. وَلَا تَكُونُوا, do not be كَالَّذِينَ خَرَجُوا مِنْ دِيَارِهِمْ, do not be like those who went out from their homes, meaning the disbelievers, the people of Quraysh, how they left their homes, بَطَرًا, insolently, that means with all kinds of arrogance. And they would say that we will defeat them, and the Arabs will see and would fear us, and they would see that, you know, how easy defeat that is. And it's all arrogance, not relying on Allah. And arrogance, by the way, is not something that a person would feel necessarily that it's arrogance. Sometimes people confuse arrogance with self-confidence, for example. You know, arrogance is when a person would refer things to oneself. When a person to reject the truth and to belittle the people, as the Prophet ﷺ said. So a person, when he goes out of his home, especially in the context of going fighting for the sake of Allah, by the proper measures, of course, and the rulings from the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, either they go out to humble themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because they're obedient to Allah, they're not showing off their actions to the people, they don't seek that, or the opposite, and the opposite ruins one's actions. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is warning the believers not to fall into the same diseases of the heart as the disbelievers. Those who went out from their diyarihim, from their homes, from their dwellings, bataran, with batar, with rejecting the truth, with arrogance. Wari'a an-nas, and to show off their actions to the people. They want to be called courageous people. They want to be called strong people, so that people would fear them, and so on. And that's why when the Prophet ﷺ, he's asked, who are the ones that, you know, a man would fight shaja'atan, out of courage, or someone would fight for whatever reasons. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, man qatal litakuna kalimatullahi al-ulya fa huwa sabilillah. Which one of these would be fi sabilillah? Whoever fights for the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be superior, then he's the one that is fi sabilillah, not for any worldly gain, not to show off. That's why arrogance and showing off, this is the ways of the disbelievers. They're arrogant when they reject the truth after it's made clear to them, and they show off for their actions because they're not seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And وَيَصُدُّونَ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, they hinder people, they avert people from the way of Allah. And this can have many different ways to it. Sabilullah, the path of Allah, whether it's fighting for the sake of Allah, whether it's the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, there are many things that can be mentioned. So one of the ways of the disbelievers is that they avert people from the path of Allah. And it hurts them so much when they see people are obedient to Allah. So they become in state of war, whether it's physical or in a non-physical matter, to make people away from the way of Allah, to make the people, you know, like them, sinners, disobedient to Allah, indulged into matters of sins and disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that their strength is gone. And the believers, they attain their strength from their obedience to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and otherwise they be left to their own desires and wills and so on. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warning the believers not to be like those who left their homes, the people of Quraysh, and out of arrogance and showing off to the people, and they avert people from the path of Allah. By one of the ways that avert people from the path of Allah is when the disbelievers are superior. So many people, they would take this, which is a very wrong way of thinking that is negates the intellect of the human beings, they would take it as an evidence that the one that is superior, that means he's upon the truth. There's nothing such a thing that is related one to the other. You know, and physically strong, it does not mean that the person is smarter than others. It means the person is upon the truth and others are upon falsehood. But this is something that foolishly sometimes the people think this way. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then at the end of the verse, he said, وَاللَّهُ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ مُحِيطٌ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with what they do is encompassing of what they do. Allahu bima ya'malun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with what they do, muhit, encompasses all of their actions. And when something is encompassed, that means there's no fleeing, there's no running away, there's no changing anything, but rather to feel this and to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompasses everything. So again, why fear other than Allah? Why fear those who, when they go out of their homes, they go out of based on arrogance and showing off to the people, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompasses them and their affairs and so on. So the person should be warned against these evil characteristics and should put things in perspective where these people that are upon these characteristics, if they're upon disbelief, they're not going to harm you. That means you need to be patient with the orders of Allah. We'll continue inshallah ta'ala with the next verse and the lessons learned, but right after the break, so stay with us inshallah.
Muhammadur Rasulullah. Muhammadur Rasulullah.
Alhamdulillah, salatu wassalamu ala Rasulullah. Welcome back. And with verse number 48 in Surah Al-Anfal, and how the shaitan, the devil, he works in these types of contexts and how he never give up. And that's an element that should never be forgotten. And therefore people need to know how they deal with the shaitan so that they're not defeated by shaitan, so they're not deceived by the ways of shaitan and thinking that it's their own selves and their own thinking and their own intellect. Verse number 48 talks about the role of shaitan in the battle of Badr, for people to learn the lesson from that. The ayah says, وَإِذْ زَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ أَعْمَالَهُمْ وَقَالَ لَا غَالِبَ لَكُمُ الْيَوْمَ مِنَ النَّاسِ وَإِنِّي جَارٌ لَكُمْ فَلَمَّا تَرَاءَتِ الْفِئَتَانِ نَكَصَ عَلَى عَقِبَيْهِ وَقَالَ إِنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِّنْكُمْ إِنِّي أَرَى مَا لَا تَرَوْنَ إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. Which means, and remember when shaitan made their deeds pleasing to them and said, no one can overcome you today from among the people, and indeed I am your protector. But when the two armies sighted each other, he turned on his heels and said, indeed I am disassociated from you. Indeed I see what you do not see. Indeed I fear Allah, and Allah is severe in penalty. So this is what the shaitan did to the people of Quraysh. وَإِذْ زَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانِ. And remember when the shaitan زَيَّن, adorned, made beautified for them أَعْمَالَهُمْ, their deeds, their evil actions. If they see it in its real way and form, they would run away from it. Shaitan, he adorns it for them. He adorns the evil deeds of these disbelievers to them. And that is to go fight the believers, to go fight the Prophet ﷺ. So he was giving them, you know, encouragement, and he came into the shape of one of the people to encourage them to go fight the Prophet ﷺ. And the goal of shaitan is what? Of course, to defeat the truth, but to keep people in disbelief till they die in disbelief. So he would lead them to their own destruction, for them to die in the state of disbelief so that they are among the people of the hellfire. That's the goal of the shaitan. So when the shaitan adorned for them their actions, وَقَالَ لَا غَالِبَ لَكُمُ الْيَوْمَ مِنَ النَّاسِ, that means no one will defeat you from among the people, that means you will be victorious, giving them false strength. وَإِنِّي جَارٌ لَكُمْ, and I will protect you, I will support you. And whether it's from that individual, in which they were afraid that some of the tribes, they might, those who do not have any treaty with them, they might oppose them and so on. So he gave them assurance that I will support you, I will take care of you. No harm will come to you from other individuals, other tribes and so on, to encourage them to go out and to fight the Prophet ﷺ. وَإِنِّي جَارٌ لَكُمْ. Then what happened? Did he fulfill his promise, the shaitan? فَلَمَّ تَرَاءَتِ الْفِئَتَانِ. When the two parties, they saw each other, that means they are in that state of war. That means they're going to meet one another in matters of fighting. نَكَصَ عَلَىٰ عَقِبَيْهِ. He turned on his heels and he ran away. This is the shaitan that gave them all kinds of promise. وَقَالَ إِنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِّنْكُمْ. And he said, I'm بَرِيءٌ مِّنْكُمْ. I distant myself from you. I disassociate myself from you. You are not from me, I'm not from you. إِنِّي أَرَى مَا لَا تَرَوْنَ. I see what you do not see, because he saw the angels, how they came to support the Prophet ﷺ and the companions radiallahu anhum in thousands. So the shaitan, he saw that, and he knew that there is no means of defeat to the believers whatsoever. إِنِّي أَرَى مَا لَا تَرَوْنَ إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهِ. That means that he said that he indeed fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَاللَّهُ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is severe in punishment. So even the shaitan runs away, but how he deals with the people. And this is mentioned also in the Quran about the hereafter. Shaitan will distance himself, disassociate himself with the human beings, those who he led them astray. And he would say that, you know, I only called them. I did not force them to do anything. He just called them to falsehood. And he adorned the falsehood for them. But then the believers, they need to be upon the truth and they need to be patient with the truth and not to be deceived by those who are deceived by the ways of the shaitan. So that's why the word zayyan, adorned, how the shayateen or the shaitan, he adorns the evil actions for the people. And how do we know this? This becomes very confusing if someone would think, you know, if the deed, a person feels that this is evil, so how would he know that this is a good thing? Is it something that depends on our feeling, as we see here, that the shaitan might make the people fear or feel that, you know, that this is not the good thing to be done, and he would make them enjoy the sins and so on. So is it confusing? It's confusing for those who are not upon knowledge. That's why having the knowledge of the truth, having the knowledge of the way the Prophet ﷺ, we have to oppose our weaknesses in ourselves. And don't want something that Allah forbade upon us. Because if we as human beings, we are weak, we are in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So how can there be any goodness in doing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hates for us to do? He's the creator of the heavens and the earth. A person doesn't see that he's been punished or seized by a lightning when he disobeys Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he thinks that this is a sign that Allah is pleased with him. So he will continue more and more into the sins. Who said that? Where is that? Is in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. In the Quran, you would find that this is people are, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is letting them to lead themselves astray unless they do not repent, unless they repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, وَأُمْلِي لَهُمْ إِنَّ كَيْدِي مَتِينَ, that the disbelievers, they think that they can continue to whatever they want. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving them so that they would fall into their own destructions and they would incur upon themselves more and more sins. So this is something that the shaitan, when he ran away after the two parties met, and he said, I disassociate myself from you, إِنِّي أَرَى مَا لَا تَرَوْنَ, that he sees what you do not see, إِنِّي أَخَفُ اللَّهِ, that he fears Allah, وَاللَّهُ شَيْءُ عِقَابٍ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is severe, intense in his punishment. The punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a severe one, and therefore people need to fear Allah. And the fear of Allah, if it does not exist in the heart, then what goodness would be in that heart? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's the one that ought to be feared, and he's the most merciful subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's great lessons that we need to humble ourselves and to always remember, because the matter is repeated by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we see here, some of the lessons learned in this is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever he calls the believers need to be attentive to what is being said. They need to learn the rulings of it. They need to apply what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from them. And to see who is the one that is addressed by this call, whether it's a person of authority, whether it's a person of, not an authority, whatever there is. So in the context of where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the believers to be firm and to make remembrance of Allah. And it shows also the benefit of being firm, especially when at times of people might fear their enemies and so on. Be firm upon the truth. Make a lot of remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what we are in need of in the time that we live in, to make so much of the remembrance of Allah, to be upon the tawheed, to be upon the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to establish the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the five daily salah, with the reading of the Quran, with the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is all means for people to be successful, to be obedient to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. These are the means of success, otherwise it's loss. And at least we would see how things are explained on the face of earth, so that no Muslim should be confused. Why this is happening? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the matter clear for us. It's the way of Allah that never changes. So obey Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do not be in disputes with one another. If you are obedient to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, still there's an extra job, an extra order here. Some people think that once you're, at least your outside appearance, that you're obedient to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there won't be no disputes. No, there will be disputes if a person is not careful, because these are separate orders from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the believers to not be in disputes. And we talked about the different levels of dispute and how that brings so much harm into the hearts and into the lives of the people, and one of which is in the battlefield and facing your enemies, فَتَفْشَلُوا وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ, that you will be in state of failure, that you will, strength will go away. So again, this is, if we can repeat this over and over again, it's worth it. Because we see the affairs of the Muslims today. whether they are in small communities or major communities, the issue of disputes. And many of these disputes is based on nothing, based on ignorance, based on opinions of the people that they watch the news more, for example. You know, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the matter very clear to us in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So being firm upon this and to stay away from these disputes and to have patience. To have patience with the obedience of Allah, to have patience away from sins, to be patient with the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and with all levels of being patient, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with the patient ones. He's with the sabirin subhanahu wa ta'ala. And warning, giving the orders, giving the instructions, that's one thing. One of the benefits that we learned that this is not sufficient unless also the person is warned from what is the opposite or what's evil. So if, for example, you're raising your child to say, do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 things, and that's it, he might do them perfectly, but he would do other things that you don't want him to do. So the perfect way of bringing, the perfect way of having a human being is to do what we are ordered to do and to stay away from sins and imitating the evil ones. So we have to imitate the believers. The believers, they imitate one another based on knowledge. They imitate the Prophet ﷺ, they follow him. And the disbelievers, they follow their own desires. They follow the disbelievers, those who are before them, and so on. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it very clear. Do not have arrogance, which is the disease of the nations that destroy them. Do not show off to the people your actions. Be humble. Seek rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And those who avert people from the path of Allah, all of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompasses them. They're not going to run away from the punishment of Allah if they do not repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how the shaitan, where people do not see him, and he sees them. And many times they would think that it's their decisions, and their decisions not affected by anything. Shaitan is adorning the evil to them, day and night. And the evil becomes adorned, that means beautified. If people see things in its real way and form and the outcome and the end of it, their life will be totally different. So not to listen to the ways of the shaitan and how he will bring all kinds of sadness and miseries in the hearts of the believers. And when it comes to the real incidents of when a person needs someone to help, the shaitan would run away from him, as the verse mentioned. The same thing will happen in the Day of Judgment, that the people will curse one another, and the shaitan will say that I only called them and they accepted my call, and he would distance himself, and they all will be in the hellfire. But the point here is to do this in this life, to stay away from imitating the disbelievers, imitating their characteristics, to be upon that, to stay away from the ways of shaitan, and to know that the shaitan will adorn evil to us. So how to protect ourselves? By holding fast to the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, to learn our perception, to learn the things that we need to do, to be upon the truth, to be patient. We all need this by being steadfast upon the deen of Allah, the Quran, and the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. And how these benefits and how can we translate this in our life? This is how the Quran becomes an essential part in our life. We cannot really function in this life unless the Quran is the criteria, the guidance for us. And that's why we need to put the effort. We need to learn the words of Allah. We need to learn the lessons from these battles, the life of the Prophet ﷺ, to see the way of Allah, to be obedient to Allah, and to be steadfast upon the deen of Allah. We'll stop inshallah ta'ala at this point and we continue next time. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who benefit from what they hear and what they listen. Wa sallallahu sallam wa baraka ala Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wa assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
الذين تابوا وأصلحوا وبينوا فأولئك أتوب عليهم وأنا التواب الرحيم.
فادعوا الله مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون.
يا زكريا إنا نبشرك بغلام.
شاهدا ومبشرا.